Okay, so the next person I've been given to talk about is Mickey James, and I feel like I've said a lot of the things I'm about to say in other interviews, so I apologize if y'all have heard it, but it may be repetitive. But obviously, the storyline that brought Lay Cool to fruition and really started our character, helped develop our character, and really, I think it was a main storyline that at the time, you know, started giving divas more screen time, and, you know, we got some longer matches. We even, you know, had a huge celebration one night. The whole, I don't even remember what it was. We were acting like Mickey was leaving for good or something. Anyway, that storyline lasted for a while. I've said it once, I've said it a million times, that I give every ounce of credit to that storyline, to Mickey. Man, that was tough on everybody. Obviously tough on Mickey, to say the least, but she was the utmost professional in that situation. She never complained about the material that was being written. She never bitched, moaned, or went and tried to, you know, change it or get it shut down. She was just like, hey, this is business. She knew, you know, she knew it was going to help us. She knew, I mean, she was already an incredibly over babyface, you know, great wrestler. People loved her. And, you know, she was one of those that came in as a heel, the whole Psycho Trish storyline. And then I think she was one of those that fans love so much that they ended up turning her babyface. So I don't think we could have done that storyline with anybody else, and it, you know, worked out that well. But man, that was tough. We got so much hate from that storyline from fans, and, you know, people sending stuff in. It was like, holy moly. Like, on one hand, it's like, sweet, this is really working. Like, we're getting genuine hate. And on the other hand, it's like, oh my gosh, I feel horrible. You know, like, what kind of message is this sending out? And you have to kind of remember, it's a character on TV. Like, I think a lot of times people forgot that, and it's, you know, it's easy to do. And I remember, you know, when I grew up watching wrestling, and I remember, like, the whole Edge and Lita storyline, you know, the live sex show and this, and I'm thinking, oh my gosh, like, I hate this guy. And of course, now he's one of my all-time favorite, and I love him to death. But anyway, back to the whole Piggy James quote-unquote storyline. I don't even know. It literally got started out of the clear blue air. I remember being overseas, and that's when they told me at the arena that day that I was going to be singing the Old MacDonald Had a Farm little vignette, and I didn't know what to think. Like, honestly, I thought they were joking at first, because I thought it was a rib on me because my singing is so horrible. I was already nervous about that, but then I, like, hid all day. I was like, I can't believe they're making me do this. Like, where is this going? I had no idea where the storyline was going to go after that. So anyway, we did that. I remember, gosh, being out at rehearsal and then playing that, and, like, I'm literally sitting on the ground by the ring, like, hiding. Like, I felt awful. There were so many times, time after time, where we would go up to Mickey and apologize in advance and be like, look, this sucks. I'm sorry. You know, obviously we didn't write this. I'm sorry. I don't know. You know, we don't know what else to say. And she, like I said, she was always completely cool with it. I'm sure it hurt. Things like that. Obviously, she's not big. Like, she's one of the smallest people. She's not, you know, there's no way anybody, you know, thought she was overweight or quote unquote Piggy James. I mean, that's just, again, our stupid, silly, Lay Cool character that we had. And like I said, I give all credit to her, because it would not have progressed in the way it did. It would have not gone, you know, as far as it did. It would not have gotten over like it did if it weren't for her. And I don't think any other babyface could have pulled that off. She pulled it off with perfection. I don't feel like Lay Cool ever got our butts handed to us by her enough. I never understood that. It was like, why isn't she, you know, killing us here or doing this or doing that? And I think the story could have even gone further, you know, because the fans week after week wanted her just to embarrass us, which, you know, I remember get the whole, I don't remember what match it was where we ended up with birthday cake. It was the Rumble, I think it was the Rumble that was real quick, and then we ended up with the birthday cake in our face, and, you know, everybody loved that because here we are getting embarrassed by her. And that was great. Gosh, like I said, I don't remember what it was. The quote-unquote Piggy James send-off, where we were acting like she was leaving SmackDown for good, and we were cutting a promo, and then she and Maria came out and cut a promo. And I remember she almost made me break character because we were talking about how dumb Maria was or something like that. And Mickey flew off the cuff and said, yeah, we all saw her. You're smarter than a fifth grader. Mm-hmm. And I'm looking at her. Oh gosh, I wanted to break character so bad. As soon as we got backstage, I was like, you almost got me. Like, I almost busted out laughing. So we had some fun moments, you know, we had fun with it. But it was tough week in and week out. And like I said, it catapulted the Lay Cool character. Vince ended up loving it as a result of that storyline, and that's kind of how, you know, things kept happening for us. And like I said, I give credit to Mickey because she, you know, she was fighting with us to get TV time, and she was fighting with us for us all to get pay-per-view matches and, you know, to raise the bar. And not many people always do that, and she did, and, you know, I'll forever be grateful for that. I think we pulled off some really good matches together. We always kind of clicked, worked well together. That always makes it fun inside the ring when you know you can work with somebody, and it, you know, you can kind of fly off the cuff while you're in there and improvise and all that. So, you know, we had some fun, and her finisher, the DDT, was always one of my most fun ones to take. But we had fun, like I said, and it was hard. It was trying at times. It was, you know, fun at times. But like I said, I can't do anything but give her complete credit for that whole storyline. And I've said that a million times. So she was a true professional, always wanting to do business, what was best for the business. And, you know, that's just what we all did. And one other thing to add to that, I forget that, you know, the night of that celebration when we cut the promos, me, Lay, and then Maria and Mickey came down, and that ended up in some type of brawl. I think we actually smashed cake in Mickey's face the night. Yes, we did. We ended up smashing cake in her face that night. And then I remember she was brilliant on her response. You know, it was like she rolled out of the ring. She stared. It was almost like she was just, that was the point that Lay Cool had gotten to Mickey with the whole Piggy James storyline. And she just looked humiliated and she ran off in tears. Nobody else could have done that the way she did it. But I remember we all came backstage, and very, very rarely does this happen, that Vince and Michael Hayes and everybody in the gorilla position were standing up clapping, saying that the girls just stole the show. So, you know, that was a very, very special moment. And again, I give her all the props in the world. So thanks, Mickey. If you hear this, I really, really appreciate you.